Welcome back, my fellow plastic benders, to 3D pen crafts made easy. My name is Decay, and today we will try to use our heat press or t-shirt press to create plastic sheets. Before I start off, I would like to mention the small cylinder object on top of the control panel in this shot. The press originally has a buzzer installed, but this thing was way too loud for my taste. So, at my, and perhaps your, own risk, I opened the control console up to remove it from the circuit board. Let's get back to it. The overall method is identical to using a clothing iron. By using the combination of temperature and pressure, the filament can be pressed into a plastic sheet. For the first test, let's go ahead and set the temperature to 170 degrees Celsius. With the difference being that the heat press has the advantage of being able to input a specific temperature, as well as setting a set distance and therefore a certain amount of pressure by adjusting the column of the top plate. I was able to straighten the filament quite a bit as I opened up the press at about 140 degrees Celsius before I laid down the filament. Just as in the research on straightening the filament, this did make them stick together. For the press, I am using both the Teflon barbecue mat as well as a baking paper. Looking beautiful already. A bit rough around the edges. With previous experiences, I can already tell that the sheet is too thick to cut nicely. Let's see what happens if we ramp up the pressure a couple of times. For the first ramp up, it does flatten it a bit more. Cutting the sheet still remains pretty hard to do, so not there yet on that part. Closing up the press seems about at its limits in these conditions. Don't want to break that on the first use. The sheet only slightly got thinner. The colors do show a bit of mixture, which is very cool to see. Cutting around the edge starts to become okay to do, but the sheet is not nearly thin and flexible enough to work with nicely. Let's try some other stuffs. This time, let's go for a solid amount of pressure, remove the barbecue sheet and ramp up the temperature, while experimenting with mixing the colors. I start off with the same temperature of 170 degrees Celsius with the max pressure of the previous test and will ramp it up to 180 degrees Celsius and then 190 degrees Celsius for the final test. The first press is already nice to see. As we know it's not thin enough, let's quickly get into the 180 degrees Celsius. Getting better already. Still a bit hard to cut, but doable to get across. Time for some color mixing, which I will do by stacking the two parts directly on top of each other. Most of the colors stayed on their respective sides. Let's do another cut and stack and increase the temperature to 190 degrees Celsius. This is looking exciting. The sheet is so thin on the sides that it starts to warp too much by just opening up the baking paper. So I will let the whole thing cool off before I open it up again. This works like a charm. There is some marble-like color mixture going on. Very cool. the sides start to break off a bit on a barbecue mat. As the sheet is pressed onto some silicone, rubber, and felt mats, it doesn't create the most uniform press. Replacing that with a solid base should improve on that part. Creating a bigger sheet will also improve the uniformity of the central section. I forgot to capture the cutting in this bit. The sheet is nice and thin, and it also has become opaque. There we go. Suggestions, questions, and requests are all much appreciated in the comment section down below, and I will try my best to reply and perhaps follow it up in future content. If this seems to be the channel that you would enjoy, please consider a like, share, and subscribe, and join me in making some fun crafts. Thanks for watching, and happy bending, everyone!